When I decided to create a YouTube channel, I didn't want to spend too much time coming up with a name. I felt, and I still feel, that the best names are the ones that come to you in the moment. So I looked at my notebook that contains a list of all the movies I want to watch. The ones I have watched, I highlight so I can still see the names. I'm really into horror, but more specifically classic horror. A majority of the classic horror movies I've watched would have been very cliche names. Wolfman, Frankenstein, Dracula. But then I saw The Raven. I remember when I wrote it down, I didn't know what it was about. And after I watched it, I felt it wasn't really a horror movie. But the way my list works, if I write it down in a specific genre, it is likely to stay there. The only exception would be if I accidentally wrote down the same movie in more than one spot. I would have to make a determination for which genre or subgenre to put it in. That is why it stuck out to me. Vincent Price's character's name in that movie is Erasmus, and I thought it was a really cool name for a wizard. I enjoy most of Vincent Price's movies. He's one of my favorite actors, and I feel his weird sense of humor doesn't really shine in a whole lot of his movies. In The Raven, however, it really does. One interesting thing about The Raven, it was another Edgar Allan Poe movie that starred Vincent Price. The first one I watched was The Pit and the Pendulum, which was a fantastic movie, arguably much better than The Raven. The Raven also has Boris Karloff, who's one of the greatest horror actors of all time, and a surprising appearance from an actor that wasn't well known at the time, Jack Nicholson. What I'm trying to get across is I think The Raven is an underappreciated film. It's not a perfect movie. It really doesn't have anything to do with the poem, and the effects are pretty bad even for the time, but I really enjoy it. As for the picture I use, that is from another classic horror film known as The Cabinet of Dr. Caligari. I gotta be totally honest, when I watched it the first time, I was not impressed. But the reason for that is because the version I watched was not very good. It's free to watch on Prime, but it's very hard to tell what you're looking at. And that is actually a very big deal for me when I'm watching a movie. Sure, old movies get a bit of a pass in terms of quality, but if I can't tell what I'm looking at, how can I possibly enjoy the movie? But here's what made me change my mind. Number one, it's not only an old movie, it's widely accepted as one of the first horror movies ever made, before horror was really even a genre of film. Number two, there's a remastered version of the movie that is extremely clear, and the style of the sets can really be appreciated. Now, normally I'm not a huge fan of remastered media. I like to experience it the way people did when they first watched it. That being said, the version I watched initially was not how people watched it when it first came out. A lot of early silent movies had certain songs that would play. Now, the tracks weren't necessarily the same across all theaters, but they were mostly similar in tone. When they were released on physical media much later, it was not paired up with the same tracks. They just put some random public domain music with it. So I believe the remastered version tries to have audio that's similar to when it came out. And I barely touched on the fact that in the remastered version, you can actually see what is happening. I don't know how they did it, but the result speaks for itself. I ordered the remastered version when I got the stimulus. It should be arriving in about a week. The main point in this video is the name comes from Vincent Price's character in the 1963 film The Raven, and the picture comes from The Cabinet of Dr. Caligari. I get a lot of questions about my name and picture I use, so I thought I would address it in a video. But another reason for this video is I will be starting a movie review series. The movies will mostly be older movies that no one really cares about anymore, and I won't be using any clips. So I'm sure this new series is going to take my channel to new heights. If you have any movies you want me to review, and they are free to watch on some video streaming service, leave a comment down below with the title and streaming service and I may end up reviewing it. But for this video, I'm going to have a poll that should be showing up right now. This poll is a list of 4 movies that I own and I have not watched yet. Vote on which one you would like me to review first. If I don't get any votes, I would just pick one randomly. Even with an incredibly small audience, I want to do polls like these at the end of my reviews, and hopefully new people come along and engage with the videos, so that way the results of the polls will be more interesting. And one more thing I want to say before the video ends. I started a Letterboxd account. Link to it will be in the description. If you are a film buff and have a Letterboxd account, please consider following me on there. Hopefully people that disagree with my videos on religion and politics can still enjoy my takes on certain movies. Thank you to everyone who watched this video. I really appreciate it.